Hello for Tuesday, August 28th, and the markets were down not much. A little bit, 69 cents on the S&P 500. This chart was in the newsletter, and you can see it had run right into this resistance line right here. So a break over that could bring it back up to the 1626, good 10-point rally. But after this move up from 1398, 1416, nice move, decided it needs a little bit of a pullback, which... Of course, as you see, we came from RSI down at 30 up to 70 when it hit this. So when it hit 70 like that all these times here and here, well, this time, look, it broke down and it was still going up. But quite often, as it gets to 70, if it starts to turn, if it's at resistance, at this point it wasn't, then we see a pullback. And that's exactly what happened. And of course, the this is short term, 15-minute chart. The Williams indicator also dipped down on the Dow. We can see the daily chart, just a little bit of consolidation, closing under the 20-day. But when it's in this kind of pattern, that's kind of understandable. The volume was lighter than it has been in many days, as you can see. So not really a big concern there. On the if we look at the futures on that one, this is a 60-minute chart, as you can see. Remember the newsletter, we showed this, that it was a measured move coming down. It was like an ABC drop off of this peak at 13309. It dropped, and this green line is the same length as this green line. So it came down an A, up in a B, and then down in a C, which basically, a little bit shy of, but basically, actually, this one's probably a little short. So you can see it a little bit short. The point is, it's basically a normal, typical measured move. It comes down, RSI goes over 30. You buy at this point. It rallied nicely, ran right into some, this line's first former resistance over here, because this is where it was resistance and it passed through, and this time, even though it came up and through it a few times, this time it became resistance again. Anyway, on this pullback during the day, you can see it came down to the trend line and bounced. That's because people are watching it, of course, and they see it here and they started to bounce, and then let's run it up, but it couldn't get up to resistance, so pulled back. Anyway, it's in this range at the moment. Not a big deal if it breaks through the 1384 roughly, that what was S1 for the day. It could come back down to test the 1300 area. Once again, on the daily, on the SPX, you can see not much to show here. It's a typical like little reversal candle. That doesn't mean you're going to reverse much, maybe just pull back. As long as it stays the 20-day moving average at 1401, staying above that would be pretty good. And the same thing is here on the futures chart. As you can see, we now could probably draw a line from here up to maybe here, that's out of the parallel channel, but you can watch that area just to see if it gets a breakout. This was, of course, it's significant high in the past, but at the moment, it's just consolidation. There really isn't a terrific setup to watch on that. The S&P, NASDAQ did better than the others, and that was probably because we might as well show Apple in here. Apple got a boost because their court case with Samsung, they won it, saying that Samsung infringed on some of their patents. You know, there's a patent for that pinching you do when you put your fingers on the screen and then open them so it expands the screen. It's unbelievable. You can get a patent on something like that. Things just second nature. Anyway, they do have one. But you can see where what that did with Apple movement. This is, of course, this is a different time frame. This is daily, but the green line here was a buy down at this level as well on our shorter time frame. You remember that when it pulled back, and here it was from this former high as it pulled back to here. Then it was when it came down and test this recently at the end of July, it was a 61.8 retracement, and RSI went over 30. That was just a kind of an automatic buy at 570, and it's run up about 100 points from there. So this was just a plain technical buy, and here it was a technical breakout. And here, after it went over the 645, it's just a normal, here it's actually not perfect, but we may have to make the chart bigger to get these lines exactly. But you can see here we've retraced 100% of it at 654. That leaves the 127.2 projection up at 678. That's exactly what it did. So it may have to pull back if people decide, you know, that judgment, that might be years before anything happens with that. It may be just months, but it could be in the retrial, and the appeals could go on for a long, long time. Anyway, that would be a valid reason for a pullback. It's a 127.2, and that's where it hit. If it breaks out above there, with a good solid close, especially with good volume. Now, of course, we're also on high RSI, much better if it consolidates. But the next Fib level would be 721. But I think we're not going to shoot right up there, I don't think. Anyway, that's what it looks like on Apple. I thought I'd show it because it was handy at the moment. And also another one that's handy, and that is the, you can watch the euro. Now remember, we've kind of decoupled. It used to be that the euro, you just watch it. And if we see a breakout, we know that the U.S. markets are going up. But lately, it hasn't necessarily been the case. But still, it's a good thing to watch this. And this short-term hour chart, it's just a nice triangle at the moment. It's holding true. Now, if it just goes sideways here, all of a sudden the triangle doesn't come into play. But this top trend line still would. But at the moment, we could see on Tuesday a breakup or breakdown. So just watch this triangle. We have this on our live streaming charts page, so you can watch for there. Did we mention the Russell? I guess not. We'll do that quickly and we'll get out of here. So here was the bounce from Friday, a good bounce, really. And now it's moved back over this red line that's right there, the 808. It closed at 810, so 2 points above it. It did back off a little bit, but that's encouraging. Small caps did okay on the dollar, just kind of flat for the day. It moved up higher than it was, I'm just saying, on the day. That's the situation in gold. Backed off, which is understandable. We had this in the newsletter as well. It reached this. We said there, it's so likely that it's going to pull back a little bit because it's right at this resistance. Same thing happened in April. So you'd expect to have this beautiful run up here. I mean, that's a big move, 60-some points, that it should pull back. And it was over the top Bollinger Band as well. So expect some maybe further consolidation there. In the GDX mechanical trade here, down 67 cents. You can see it's been along quite a while. So you've got many dollars in here. If you bought it 41.50 or 42, you're up over $5 on that. Not bad. And SLV, you see, oh, I see. That's why it's down there. It's also, what it do? It's flat. Is that true? It is flat on the day. Is that amazing? Anyway, that's what it looks like at there. Okay, so now we're going to go where? Let's go over to what happened with some of the stocks. There wasn't a lot of activity, actually. There was a couple that gapped up. We'll show those. But I'm just pointing out a couple of things. Green Dot, you can see it had broken out. It pulled back, but it remained as we expected. Above the 20-day right here on the pullback, it's been going up. It needs more volume. But that may move again. You can watch it if you want to rebuy over that 1130. That'd be a possibility as well. BRAX. You can see it did get up to this 158, 160. We mentioned it because it had very good volume, more, double the normal volume, 1.8 million shares. So we did post it, but it just couldn't follow through. It gapped up a little bit right to there, not much, with just below that line. But we posted that it's at that 160, 161, and it couldn't break over 160. So watch that one. It may do so in the future. And Hertz, they bought some other car company, and it was a big gap up. We posted this because it was gap up right away. And you can see this where it opened above 15. This triggered on Friday, so I'm sure a lot of you are holding it because it closed right behind the day. You wouldn't have been stopped out on Friday. Probably maybe took a little profit, but you were rewarded on Monday with a big gap up. And when you see these big gap ups like that, it's a good idea to obviously watch the 15-minute chart. And after you'd be out of it within 15 minutes probably, but it's a good idea to watch those. Anyway, but a super volume, so watch this as it pulls back. It might have a chance to get back in there. So watch it for possible entry. RL, Ralph Lauren, why do we have it showing here? I don't know. I'm showing some that had triggered in the past, but this one hasn't quite yet. Maybe just to show that it's still, we have the 50-day and the 200-day just about touching. And they a lot of times cause some fireworks on the upside, and that may be the case. And showing the SVNT pharmaceuticals, once again, this shows you. Here we go back over RL. Notice how the 50-day and the 200-day are about to touch. Now, that doesn't mean it's going up, but if it breaks out and they're touching, the chances are we get a good move, and you can see what happened to SVNT. And what do you have? You have the 20-day and the 50-day just touching. It looks like the 20-day just wants to go above and another a big gap up. After it gapped up slightly in a buy on Friday, it did so again. And here we got DK. This had moved up. This one we liked the layout of it. It moved up and then it pulled back to where? Right exactly to the same support. So that second chance to buy, and that was rewarded as it moved up. Now we'll see if it can move out over the $25.72 area. Okay, now let's get to additions to the watch list. And that we've got a BLDR, you can see over 430. This was a buyback down here as well. We had it recently around $4, so it's moved up, but the pattern consolidating out moved up in 3 days of consolidation. Could move in the next couple of days above that 430, 431, up next to that 475 area, right up here where this one is. So that's one to add to the list, as so far as Discovery Labs as well. Oh, this we did, I guess we did put it on the list, but it had good volume. It's 1.5 million shares, way above the average of volume. It's just a tricky one. I don't know. It's within this congestion still, but it might be a good day trade for 5 or 6% just from here up to here. This would be 5 or 6%. Now, if it takes off from there, could be another story altogether and be a good percent. But 4, 5, 6% right in here may be able to grab it. So we didn't put a price on it. We just want to point it out. FRAN looks pretty good, over about $35.30. That's right where we have the line, and then you can see the 36.11, 35.69 or other short-term targets. We need some more volume. It needs to be on the upside, of course. GIB over 26.17, pretty understandable. We don't like the big volume both Friday and Monday, but it hasn't changed much in price. So that could reverse, and we don't own it now. If we owned it, we'd be cautious and have a stop right underneath probably Friday's low. But since we haven't bought it yet, if the things turn around, it looks good volume, breakout over 26.17, kind of interested in that. MNKD, this is a continuation because it closed right at this resistance, 260. Again, it's a low price stock. You may get 8 cents here to this 268, or it may go up to 280 again, which is then a decent move, good 8 or 9%. Once again, it had increasing volume. It looks like this may break out. So we're adding that. And lastly, we have PRGO over about $111. Big volume gap down, but it didn't run into this and then back off right away. It consolidated sideways with higher volume, which suggests it's going to be a move. Maybe it's just going to be a $1 or $2 move, small percentage-wise, but we'll see how it happens. Anyway, 111 would probably be an entry here, especially if it has good volume, and maybe peel some off as it moves up. So that's what we have for this Tuesday. Hope you have a great trading day. Thanks a lot for watching. Do pay attention to the tweets before the market opens. A lot of times you can look at, we post the gappers up and down, and with enough time, usually you do it about 20 minutes to 30 minutes before the market opens. You can take a look. There's usually not that many, maybe 7 to 20 of them. You can just quickly look at the news of those and then look at the charts of those. A lot of times you can find a good morning day trade by the chart if it isn't gapped up too much, or if there's, you can just tell by looking at the charts. A lot of times there's ones of those that can be quite useful. So otherwise, we'll see you on a Tuesday during the day and then after market closes with some new ideas in Market Wrap. Thanks a lot. Bye.